In this lesson, we'll explore mechanistic strategies to help you solve organic reaction mechanisms. We'll begin with a detailed discussion of the elementary steps as a whole, with the goal of establishing a general, exhaustive process for identifying all reasonable steps that starting materials or intermediates may undergo. Then we'll move on to discussing concrete mechanistic strategies in the context of an example. By the end of this lesson, you should have the ability to propose reasonable reaction mechanisms with or without the elementary steps provided. The ability to effectively determine organic reaction mechanisms depends on a firm understanding of the nature of their building blocks, the elementary steps. Energetically, we can represent the process of a reaction on a reaction coordinate diagram, which charts the energy of a compound as it transforms from reactants to products. Notice that the energy landscape is a series of peaks and valleys, culminating in a final valley, which is the product. Each peak is a high-energy species known as a transition state, and each valley is a starting material, intermediate, or product. The progression from an energy valley through a single transition state and into a second valley is known as an elementary step. Remarkably, there are a limited number of possible elementary steps that organic compounds can undergo. Ignoring pericyclic reactions, there are 10 elementary steps, and they're listed for you here. We can bring even more order to this list by classifying each step according to the frontier orbitals involved. Classifying the elementary steps in this way does two things. It reveals hidden similarities between apparently different steps, and it allows us to think about keying structures in molecules that indicate that certain steps are possible. In the table you see here, we've listed the unoccupied frontier orbitals as the columns and the occupied orbitals as the rows. Each entry in the table is a unique frontier orbital interaction. Let's place the elementary steps on this table according to the FMO interaction involved in each. First of all, the DN step is unique because it involves a no-bond interaction. The electrons in a sigma bond simply move to reside on an atom. However, we'll see that this step bears some similarity to other steps that form bonds. Next, I'll lay down the elementary steps that proceed through pi type or side-on orbital interactions. Notice that the 1,2,R and DE steps, like the DN step, involve a sigma to A interaction. Finally, here are the elementary steps involving sigma type interactions. Interestingly, the SN2, PT, and EB steps all involve N to sigma star interactions. The only difference between them is based on the nature of the sigma star orbital and whether the process is intra or intermolecular. Why is this classification useful? Notice the Lewis structures drawn above and to the left of the table. Molecules that contain these Lewis structures are liable to undergo the elementary steps indicated in the corresponding rows and columns. For instance, compounds containing double bonds may undergo the AE or ADN steps. These keying structures will help you sort through reasonable possibilities for mechanistic steps. It's up to you to use your chemical knowledge to determine which possibility is best in a given case. Let's look at a couple of examples. A molecule that contains a lone pair adjacent to a good leaving group is primed to perform beta elimination. Examples of this structure include the tetrahedral intermediates of acyl and imine substitution, which I've drawn for you here. On the other hand, cations next to groups that can depart by leaving behind electrons, such as H+ or carbocations, are well suited for the 1,2,R or DE steps. Here's an example of one such substrate. Hopefully this webcast has demonstrated to you the usefulness of knowing the orbital interactions associated with each elementary step. By determining the MOs present in starting materials, we can generate a finite list of possibilities for any mechanism. In the next webcast, we'll begin to put mechanistic strategies in action to solve a rearrangement mechanism.